Hello student, today also I am going to perform experiment number 2 and with another sample, that is dimethyl aniline. Okay, so this is a sample. I already took some sample inside the sample container and now I am going to use this one for the experiment. So according to flow chart, so like the solid sample, first of all, we have to perform the preliminary test, and then after that, we have to perform the confirmatory test. So, in the preliminary section, we have to follow the flow chart. And the first test for the liquid sample, according to flow chart, is what? We have to check whether sample is miscible or immiscible in water. Okay. So, for that, what we have to do? We have to take a test tube. There, we have to add some samples. And here we have to add some distilled water. Now we have to check whether this one is visible or not. So you can see in water our sample is not miscible because two layers are appear over here and some oily bubble like things is floated inside the solution. So looking this, you can say sample is immiscible in water. So now what you have to do, as it is immiscible, then we have to follow this section. Okay, as our sample is immiscible in distilled water, then the coming test is what? We have to check the miscibility in dilute HCl again. Okay, so what we have to do, again we have to take some sample in a test tube and there you have to add dilute HCl. So I am going to take some sample and here I am going to add some dilute HCl. Now you have to check whether it's miscible or not. Initially you can see lots of bubbles are floated inside the test tube. Now we have to shake this one and we have to check whether it's miscible or not. Yeah, now see, nothing is present, no separated layer. Okay, so that means you can consider this one is miscible inside the dilute HCl. Okay, so as it is miscible in dilute HCl, so we have to follow this track, okay, this path. As it is miscible, then coming test is what? Diazo coupling test. So for diazo coupling test, what you have to do? First of all, we have to take an ice bath like this. And there you have to put sample plus HCl solution. This one is, it's already prepared. So this we have to put over here. We have to take another test tube. There we have to take sodium nitrite solution, that also you have to put inside the ice bath. And in a third test tube, what you have to take? Some of the alkaline butanophthal solution. So this also you have to put over here. After putting these three things inside the ice bath, we have to wait 6 to 7 minutes. Okay. Okay, fine. So we are going to wait for 6 to 7 minutes. Okay. So 6 to 7 minutes over. Now we have to mix this solution. And ice bath you can easily prepare. Just take a beaker, take some ice and add little bit water into that gives you a ice bath. By this you can prepare a ice bath. So what we have to do, first of all we have to mix sample HCl and NaNO2. And this one we have to add in the alkaline butanophthal solution. Okay. So positive observation of the diazocoupling test is scarlated red. Okay. But this is not look like scarlated red. So you can consider this one is the negative observation. So it's not. So you have to follow this part. No response. Okay. This is not scarlated red. So no response. So after that, what we have to do? We have to do the another test, that is the K4 efficiency test. Okay. So for K4 efficiency test, what we have to do? We have to make a dilute HCl solution of provided sample, and there we have to add the K4 efficiency solution. Okay. So I'm going to take some drops of sample over here. And we have to add dilute HCl into this. Yeah, now it's miscible. Now here we have to add K4 efficiency solution. So this is the K4 efficiency solution, potassium ferrocyanide. This one we have to add over here. Okay. So you can see a white precipitation come inside the test tube. That means what? We got a positive observation. So observation of the K4 efficiency test is what? White PPT or no PPT? So we got white PPT, so we can say our sample is dimethyl aniline. Okay. So that means what? All the preliminary tests of our provided sample we are completed. Now what we have to do? We have to perform the confirmatory test for this particular sample, for this dimethyl aniline. Okay. So, as we completed preliminary test, now we have to perform the confirmatory test. So, first test in the confirmatory section is K4 efficiency test. Okay. So, as we completed K4 efficiency test in preliminary section, so we are not going to perform this one again. And the second test is what? Diazocoupling test. This also we are performing the preliminary section, but this one which is written over here, this is little bit different from the preliminary one, so that is why we are going to perform this one. So for this, what we have to do? We have to take a test tube, and there we have to take some aniline. And into this, we have to add some dilute HCl. This one we have to put inside the ice bath. And in another test tube, we have to take some sodium nitrite solution . This also you have to put inside the ice bath. And the third test tube, what do you have to take? We have to take the sample . So into this I am going to put some dilute HCl. So these three things you have to put inside the ice bath. What are the things? Aniline ACL test tube, NaNO2 test tube and sample ACL test tube. That we keep for 5 to 6 minutes, and then after that we are going to add. So 6 minutes over, now we are going to mix this thing. First of all, we have to diazotize. So first of all, aniline ACL and NaNO2 we have to mix. Now diazotized benzene diazonium chloride is prepared. Now this one we have to add into the sample ACL solution. Okay, so this type of dye we got from this diazocoupling test. Okay, so now coming test, what we have to do? That one is malachite green test. So for malachite green, what you have to do? We are not going to do the test in following this procedure. We are going to do the test using ZnCl2. Okay, so for this, what we have to do? We have to take some sample. So, actually, for this test, malachite green test, dimethyl aniline is to benzaldehyde will be 2:1. So, if I take 2 drops of dimethyl aniline, then I have to take 1 drops of benzaldehyde. So, I am just take 6 drops of dimethyl aniline. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and here we have to add 3 drops of benzaldehyde. Now in this we have to add little bit ZnCl2 zinc chloride. Okay, and this one we have to put in the Bunsen burner. Strong heat required for this test. So now you can see the green color things. Yeah, green color things is appear. And this one is the malachite green. Okay, so as we complete all the confirmatory tests of dimethyl aniline, that means we can say our sample is confirmed to be dimethyl aniline. Okay, so that's all guys, thank you.